haunt you. Go ahead. Look behind you. We don't mind.
The creation. We all started out gloriously. It was perfect. No harm. No pain. No suffering. We loved one another. We all were a family. But he came about. He made us into beasts. Savages no more than a monster. He tried to contain us. We fought back with all our might. He didn't know it until it was too late. We snuck in the midst of the witching hour. We rendered him vulnerable, virtually helpless. We tore into his flesh. We broke his bones, and gouged his eyes, and ripped the tongue out. We wanted him to suffer. We left him then, and looked upon our handiwork. We left him. A torn and bloody mess. The eyes were shredded and scattered around on the floor. His organs were used to choke him. And the flesh was not flesh anymore. It was a pile of congealed blood. We congratulated ourselves and left him for the humans to take.
Who are we? We like to keep ourselves hidden in the dark, fleeting from shadow to shadow. You think you see us, and oh, you do. But we like to make you think you didn't. It's irritating, isn't it? Knowing that we are there, but not seeing us. We think it's funny to see you so distressed and confused. You humans. So fragile. You know this, but you choose to hide it.
Our parents. So, you want to know what we look like? Let me explain. We are not physical. Well, in your sense. We cannot be touched. We cannot be moved or otherwise shifted in any direction. We are the plague of the mind. You do not know that we exist. You just call us paranoia. But trust me, it gets much worse. The pulse-grinding sensation of knowing that we are following you. But a label is all you have of us. You've seen us. Trust me. The little shadows out in the corner of your eye. That's us. We don't take physical form. We are your minds. We play you with shadows from the darkest corners of the abyss. The emptiness we provoke in your mind. And the insecurity of not being alone. we do our jobs. And you're only making it enjoyable for us.
The fragile perception of rest. We choose to make you nervous. But you don't know when. Every waking moment you spend will be subject to an undercurrent of fear. A sense of surreal irritation. And you pretend it was a dream. You can't handle the truth. You would break if you knew of us. We have names. Long forgotten though they may be. The last thing you need is to be guarded by emotion. Motion is a fragile thing. Your own emotions set you against yourself, and you don't realize it. Your emotions tear you from the inside out, while we claw you from the outside in.
The names of the beasts. We've been known for years now. But we've been given simple, vague names. Fear. Hate. Envy. Lust. Greed. And death. We take on the names of your emotions. Just to toy with your mind. And show you that you are never alone. You at least think you aren't alone. But we will abandon you. It's happened in ages past, and history repeats itself. We leave you alone and form one beast. Loneliness.
Final rest. We made peace with the world when we died. But we live on. You know we do. Our existence is not to be ignored. You know what happened to the last person that ignored us? He died. A brutal, terrible death it was. His lungs were ripped open. His heart was placed in his hands while it beat slowly. And his entrails were spread out, making a ring around the body. And his face. We completely shredded his face to make him unrecognizable. Our customs are really simple. Ignore us and die. Or continue to live with us. The paranoia. If you choose to ignore us, we might make you die by your own hand. Or maybe, if we want, we will send you on your way to the other world, alone.
Detonation. Always remember, you are alone, and no one can protect you from yourself. Your soul. It's going to be one of us. Remember that. You are ours. One way or another. And you will live with the paranoia. You will live with us. This